a place where services can be, you know, just tucked away. But it also is a place where places are not always designed for safety. And since it is really tucked away in the ground, does not have light enough, ventilation, ideally, it should have, okay. I have some wonderful examples. Unfortunately, pandemic does not allow us, but I remember taking a batch out to Pune. Kimaya and myself, we did that. Suzlon building designed by Christopher Benninger, and the way he has designed basement is like just another space, you know. No, you would not feel that this is a basement because he has taken entire services down. All your water systems are down. The way the water is reused in the building, so that happens at the top level. But then we say, na, there is an aeration pond, there is a finishing pond, sunlight pond, whatever, jo bhi naam dena hai. That happens at the basement level, which is like a nice, beautiful courtyard, which happens and around which you have the courtyard. So courtyard is just another space which has awesome light coming in. There is no need of full day lights happening there. Ventilation is fantastic. Minimum mechanical ventilation. Maximum utilization. So it is so beautifully designed. So it is the myth and the way the architects design basements that, you know, most of the time we get the feeling, acha basement hai na, matlab services. But it's not that, guys. You need to then now twist your thoughts and say that basement is another extension of the building, and then how designing that building or that part of the building which has equal amount of light, ventilation, and a space can be called as a space and not just a service space. Okay, so yeah, I just wanted to clear that. I think I'm going to take down the attendance. It's only 69, so okay. I have downloaded the attendance. Okay, I'll be taking one at the end of the lecture. So if you miss that, so there will be a compilation of both. We have been asked to do that, so I'm doing it. Okay, so now coming to the I'll go full screen mode. Okay. Now, can you see my screen? Yeah. Can you see? I've changed my. Oh no!
We can
again,
still
there
see
is
a white slide.
But it's a blank thing. It's a blank slide. I already changed. Chalu ho gaya. Yesterday also, not yesterday, Tuesday, there was a lag. I think I'll have to share again. I have to get out and do it again.
It changed to the next slide, Abhi, just before you stopped sharing.
Oh, I saw it. Okay. Can you now see my slide? Yes. Okay. Tuck this in, right?
Yes, it's full screen now.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So we will be talking about basements today and how the basement has to be planned and what all services are actually put inside for larger basements. And if you have basements for any other reason, say for example, you have a small bungalow, okay, and you need to design a basement for it. So how would you then design a basement? So there are various kinds and typologies of basement depending on the scale of the building and so forth. You will have to figure out that what all kind of services and what all kind of design elements that will go into your basements. Okay. So, what all need you to take care when you are designing basements? Okay, there are a lot of constructional. I'm not going to go this into detail. I'm just touching the points. Vikram is going to take you through the construction. This thing, I've already changed the slide. Okay, and I don't know why this lag. I am really worried because this is going to happen. Then I will really need to do something about this because I've already changed the slide. Okay, so the first care that one has to do is when you dig.
Do one thing. Stop sharing. Then go full screen. Then press the Windows button and then try sharing again.
Okay. Okay. So I stop sharing. I go there. Okay.
No, no. Stop sharing.
Now I go and
go to PPT. Then
yeah,
full screen.
Full screen.
Yeah. Press the Windows button. Okay. Come back to Teams.
Okay. Press. Window button kahan pe hai mera? Okay.
Be on the bottom left side of your
yeah. So that, but where? Okay, and now I go to the
Teams and then share your full screen PPT.
Okay, maybe that will help. Because on Tuesday also, when I was taking second year, oh boy. Such a big lag. And it's not that my internet is not working. It's showing full scale. I mean, so I am not, and I have been working since morning, so I didn't face this problem.
Meena,
so there are days when, yes.
Can I help with
okay.
sharing
screen? So I got it. Now, can you see my screen? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, got it. Okay, so I will check this out.
Your right hand side, bottom corner of the screen, there's some box thing. If you have added it or
no,
you can see it on
there. I have no. I know I can see it because I, as I told you last year also, I don't have PC mic, so I have to use my mobile. So I'm seeing it on my mobile, and I have no idea why it is there. But don't worry, it's not going to really. Okay, so there are some construction. Sorry for the delay. What all construction care one needs to take in the basements? First is the displaced soil effects. Okay, please write these down. Okay, I have only the points here, and if you wish, you can then Google out and figure out what it is. So basically, when you dig basements, you have to dig deep. Earth, and we all know that we have retaining walls, and we do that because the earth has a tendency to, you know, thrust and it falls back. So when you do deep basements, and first of all, they are becoming very common in all kinds of your, you know, business districts hai, ya prime high-rise developments hai, ya even small houses, for the simple reason is parking is now the basic need. It's coming up, okay, which is actually not a right thing that is happening in the city, but that is the common thing that and where there is definitely land area is limited. So some nowadays people even have land basements and offices set up there, and a lot of things happen in the basement. It is also common in cities where, as I already said, poor planning hota hai. So parking is not there, not provided. So instead of street, people now opt for either high-rise parking or they opt for the basement parking. Okay. So most of the buildings now have the need to have the basement for the reason of the parking. Now, another bylaws that has been added, and that is that if you have your square feet area of the house is say more than 700 square feet or 800 square feet, I don't know exactly the figure, which you will be doing, I guess, though not in that kind of a detail. Mostly the bylaws that will be taught to you would be environmental and some other land related. But yeah, the bylaws is something that you will have to learn and apply as and when you get the project. It's not something that you mug up because they tend to change. Government change, bylaws change. So what happens is nowadays they say that if you have 3-bedroom hall kitchen, which is amounting to about say 800 to 900 square feet, then probably 2 parking has to be given. So more and more parking space are demanded now by the BMC. And so the space for the parking is a problem. Anyways, so the question here is when I say displaced soil effect, essentially what it happens is that the soil will exert pressure and will want to come in the place where you have emptied it. Okay, so one has to do the shoring. Okay, aapko pehle short shoring karna padega, so that the at least temporary basis pe you can hold the earth back. Then once you construct your retaining wall for the base, of course you will do the foundation and everything, but when the retaining walls come up there, then you can remove the shoring. Or nowadays what they do is they make shoring only a kind of a retaining wall. So you know, the costing comes down and all that. So there are ways now people are thinking about how do you take care of this problem. Okay, the second one is the water table we all know that Mumbai has a very high water table, and I'm talking about Mumbai because Mumbai is, first of all, a very dense city where basement is very important. Secondly, it does have water table issues. So yes, this is a dicey situation. If I were to do a basement, say in Ahmedabad or Indore, or I wouldn't be so worried about water table, okay? Because that's like way deep down. And with the depletion that is happening, still going down. So, but in cities like Mumbai, Goa, where the water tables are pretty high, you definitely hydrostatic pressure, differences that are created. What happens is you have aquifer, and then you are cutting it down because you are taking that aquifer out. So what happens is aquifer gets a release, so it becomes kind of a pond, and you are extracting that out. Plus, you need to then now shut that off. So that extracting of pani, okay, it happens at a very massive scale. And basically, you know that the pressure is always from the high pressure to the low. There is nothing happening here. It's a low pressure. And obviously, the pressure of the water from the high pressure area will gush in. So to stop that is, again, a big issue. Okay, that is the start point. What happens when all comes up? Pressure to rahega hi, okay, unless the aquifer dries up or something. But yeah, so this kind of issues are there, and that is the reason why you will need a very strong and a good structural engineer who will guide you through this. Basements and foundation definitely requires a very good coordination between structural engineer, architect, and the contractor. Okay, client ka isme koi kaam nahi except giving the money. So so this is the second issue that one has to really take care of. Okay. And usually we know that the water is encountered at 3 meters level and basements are at around 4 meters. So obviously water is not the issue. And what will be the solution for that? Okay. Now, as the depth of the basement increases, now sometimes you go double basement. So you have one basement and then you have double basement. Yani niche ek basement jata hai. So either you take a big, huge ramp, but generally people don't opt for the ramp because imagine you have to go 6 meters down. What will be the size of the, I mean, there will be no justification of the basement if whole of the part of the basement is just taken up by the ramp. Anna? So then you will have to go by those hydraulic, which will go up and down and all that kind of stuff that will have to be taken care of. Now, when you are going so much deep down, okay, what are the additional structural thing that you will need to take care of? Okay, you need to, I mean, of course, retaining walls are there. You will need to give ground anchors. And I'm sure Vikram is going to do all that. And this is not a construction lecture. I'm just giving you these pointers. So Justin, need to find out, you just go and find out. Okay, because if I start taking construction lecture, I'll never finish services. So there are a lot of these solutions there. And of course, the slab will be there. So that in case of any sinking of the sand, there will not be crack develops. Okay, so so raft becomes very important. But then raft alone doesn't work. Okay, if there is no good foundation happening below, I mean, you are not getting good bearing, then of course raft with. Sort of 1 second, guys. I have to take this call. I will just come back. Okay, can you hear me, guys? I'm back. Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you. But Meena, your PPT is still stuck. We can just see the first point.
So that is the first point only, Jared. Can you see the third point?
No. We can just see the first one.
See the first point.
अब क्या करूँ मैं? So Mohit, I went through your strategy, but that also seems not to be working. What to do?
Meena, if you could share this with me, I can project it for you and then change the slides as per your requirement.
Okay. No, but actually, you know what? I wanted to draw on it. Then if you are sharing, then I won't be able to do it.
Meena, you might have to update your Teams app.
Arey, abhi kiya yaar. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'll close the recording. I'll go through this one whole thing again. Sorry for this, but yeah, I'm stopping the recording for time.